Yeah, that was a nice tune. I think many of those cultural music players do it because it is cultural. It is within their culture, and I think they I haven't the faintest idea what they are singing about, but maybe sometimes we will understand such languages in the near future, where Google can translate even the smallest verse. We need translation. Maybe translation is a good topic. Translation. Translation. Yeah, sometimes we need translation. I use the translator more or less all the time because I am in different languages which I'm both writing and talking. Mostly writing, because I express myself through my writing. And in order to be understood, I try to translate it in different ways. I also try to write things in different ways so it becomes more resonant with the recipients. And what makes me believe that translation or another way of doing stuff is good. Or sometimes we have this feeling of when I'm talking with people and I try to explain where or how or something, I try to make the other people, the other recipients, associate with what I'm talking about. So association is a way of translating what your message is all about. If I want to point to the nearest, for example, we can take where I'm attending every as much as I can attend the city church, and you are asking for the road to the city church, and I will pinpoint by association. Now, if you have never been to, I will the signs. I have been here once or two times. I can go by associations. I can ask, do you know where the church is? Do you know where the harbor is? Do you know where the railway station is? So when you are at the railway station, you can look south to the harbor and you will see a spire of the church. Yes, down below the entrance of that church, the biggest church in Sandefjord, made by bricks, red clay bricks. You can see the city church that is alongside the road. And if you are traveling there, You are close to the place I am attending. That's a way of association. And if you have been to Sandefjord before, you will say, ah, yes, I remember the church. I remember the harbor. I remember the railway station. We went there because we want to get away as soon as possible from Sandefjord. And that is translation by association. You have different associations. If you have some way of talking, you can illustrate it with pictures, with the graphics, with explanations within some musical term or other terms. It's not that hard to understand that translate, we need translation. And I know when I'm debating people that they have something in their mind. I just asked a salesman, because he had these USB, like this, and you can have this. And he sold more or less 10 USB pins. And it stood a price tag, but I didn't know whether the price tag was for everyone, the lot, or single one. So I asked him in different ways in order to translate my question. It's a way of translating, because translation is a way to make the recipient understand. So when I do this talk, I find ways. Maybe it's not clever because I do it in a one-man room. I do it in a single form. I am just a expresser. I'm just a talker. When I listen to podcasts or different programs where they are together, there are different ways they misunderstand each other, and different way they come in alliance with each other. What did you really mean, and what is the case for your arguments and topic? So that is a way of converting. Translation is a converting in the degree that it can serve the full meaning of what you are trying to say. That was different aspects of translation. And it is an interesting word, because we read in the Bible about Babel, the Tower of Babel, and it seems to be uniformed language back in those days before Babel. Babel is a mixture of every language. Babel is, when you talk Babel, is a word for something you don't really understand. What are you talking? What kind of a Babel are you talking about? We have this babbling, the word babbling in Norwegian. He is only babbling. I think it is also an English word. We can Google it, because it can be a little bit interesting. Babbling. It's regarded as foolish, incomprehensive, excited, rapidly speaking or babbling, yes, very blah blah blah, yeah yeah yeah, something like that, that is not really coherent with what you really, it is an expression at the same time that it gives no meaning, it gives no sense. So if I'm just sitting here and babbling, no one will really get my points. So I may have an understanding of talking in different ways than I used to do, because when I started writing, when I started talking, it was why don't you understand when I'm talking to you? How come you can't understand what I say? But I couldn't relate my speaking to, I couldn't really see in perspective the comparison between what I said and what my thoughts were all about. So I have used all the years since that realization that my thoughts is not accordingly to my writing, to my speech. It should be in alliance with I was talking about fragments that belong together, and I wanted to erect some of maybe a misunderstanding that lies can't coincide with the truth. Lies is an extended version and a different narrative and truth than the truth. So if you extract, if you convert or pervert words to be lies, to have an opposite meaning without any sense whatsoever to the true fact, it doesn't belong there, just so it's clear. And you can't have enemies. You can't include enemies that are determined to extinct the people that include and try to unite. As the claim of Israel, they have to accept and do the right thing, but the right thing for in this situation is the wrong thing. If you want to include terrorists in your backyard, if you want to cooperate or deal with terror, it can't be, you have to have a uniform idea of what is the right. So back to the truth or to the translation. You need some truth from what you are thinking, what you are minding into the true fact of what you are saying, writing. The expressed words, either it's in writings or in vocals, it have to bear the same truth as you have internally, that your mind is all about. So many times I experienced very early that I couldn't really express, it was kind of a dyslexia, I couldn't really express my true meaning, true opinion through letters or words. So I think I have been working on that ever since. I think I started really writing from the... I read the Bible. I think that had been a profound impact. And I also think that to receive the Holy Spirit is a way to open your mind into the ability to see the objective differences between your mind and your words. I think the Holy Spirit is there in order to make assured that you are telling the truth, because if not, you will have a bad conscience about what you are saying. If you lie, for example, that is a statement that will haunt you until you erect it. You can't keep something like that without trying to erect. It's just how it is. And I think the Holy Spirit is more than minding and a judge. The Holy Spirit is enlightened. The Holy Spirit is enlightening our mind into full awareness and insight in such, for example, the coherency between my thoughts and my my expression. I think it is people are not minded if they are not used or practice all this. For some it is more easy because they are not confined. In my upbringing I was confined in my own mind. I think the confinement was a jail, it was imprisoned me in some way. So of course I needed some external force or some inspiration in order to enlighten myself. Not that I did it, but I think this kind of a quality in these forces to enlighten me into realization. So you see, the Holy Spirit is translating by projecting the mirror of myself. I don't think that is common for Christians to develop. I think it is more Kabbalistic to talk about such enlightenment. I have no clue, but I think it is more into the Judaism than Christianity, because I think Christianity is stereotyping every spiritual statement. Like the Holy Spirit is giving you power and the guts to do it. The brave, you have some stamina. But I think also the Holy Spirit is working alongside ourselves in order to enlighten our mind, so we don't get into animalistic level, that we are raised up over the animalistic, so that we can be coherent, be understood. Because a dialogue between myself and me is much needed when I see my acts, my practice, and say, oh, something is wrong, something is not coherent, something is not making sense. So I have to try to figure out what is the issue here. It is more or less the same as you try to explain something in your mind to another person. So I think that everyone we meet is some side of us that we are focused on. I think it is more easy for some to interact in a more easy way. I don't know how to say it, but in my world I try to interact with people on a level that I may be improving myself. in a way. So I do the ordinary stuff. I say hi and have a good day and so on. Yes, the easy, superficial way to interact. And when it comes to something of a talk, I express openly my personal dealings, my mind, what I was dreaming about, and I have no objections to that, because it can be, for me, a mirroring. When I talk with other people, it's a kind of a mirroring on myself, how they respond, in order to both feel normal and fine. I'm not that odd, I'm not that strange, because people, when I do that, people are opening up, as I did some translation for them in order to verbalize my thoughts of the deepest, not the deepest truth or privacy, but it is just a common topic that they could at least come out and talk about, because no one would ever talk about such and such that I do. So, you see, in this translation is both for yourself and for others, that you when you are open, and if you are brave enough to talk about such and such, they will understand that, wow, this is quite good to talk about, this is enlightening, this is more easy than taboo-like topic. So that is a good way to see how people are transforming out of this translation. And translation into different languages. I didn't come to that, but it is, I think, as I get more and more used to other people, other cultures, different nationalities, I see that we are all human beings. We don't need all that kind of a translation in order to understand the profound similarity that we all have. That we all, in a way, belongs together, because we need only a translation in order to find out that we are quite similar, we are quite the same. So people are ashamed of themselves, because maybe the translation didn't arrive to them. You see, the gospel is, when we say that the gospel is for every person, we are missionaries, we are preachers, we want to preach the good news. It's a kind of a translation in itself. Gospel is a translation of what God expressed through Jesus. And now we will say, for so much God loved the whole world, you and me. So it is a kind of a transformation of love. We try to convey God's love into other human beings. Because I think, I have not talked so much about it, but love is very basic, very profound and big issue. So I may never talk about it lightly, at least. I can do it lightly, but to talk about love is, that is, but to say something about doing good, to do good is a translation of your love. To do good for others is in its deepest sense, it's a translation of your own way of loving people, yes, by doing good. So translation is acts, It's not only words you try to express, which is very important, but it is also the translation of acts, that when people are foreign to each other, they act more like this, they behave more figuratively, and do the, I want to eat now, can you hear me? And so on, I can't see you. All these acts shows and proves that it is more easy to understand what you are saying. If you want to say my name is Ole, I say my name Ole. It's very, you try to do it in a simple way in order to translate the idea that my name is Ole. Ole, me. You, whatever your name is, don't say it. I won't hear it anyway. But in due time, we will meet each other. We will unite. You can see me and other people in your own mirror. So you can understand that it is the idea of love, the idea of words, the idea of your want to express yourself. Don't need so much translations, but yet you understand. Translations is for understanding, so that we can understand each other. We ask, instead of claiming you said that, we can ask, what did you mean? Not to be hurtful. If you try to express something and the other one gets hurt, you can say, what did you really mean? Or you can express what you heard in order to convey, what did you mean by that? In order to avoid hurtful accidents, as they would say, if you don't really believe that this person want to hurt you, just ask a second time, what did you mean by that? Today, I think there is much more egoism. I am hearing much about hurt against Jewish people. Maybe we need some translation of who Jews are. That they are not bad. They are good people. They are helping the whole world, yet they are hated by the whole world. It gives no sense. It gives no meaning. The translation have gone wrong, totally wrong, lost in translation. And if you are focused on only one bit of a fact, and you don't get the whole perspective, you are lost even more in translation. If you want to pick out, cherry pick out the news from the news and don't take the whole concept, you don't understand much and you're moral corrupt. I want to say that before Shabbat comes in, I am going to be with the dog and maybe we can have Shabbat together. The dog needs to be a little bit more Jewish, so I can like it even more. Okay, my friends, Shabbat Shalom to all of you, and I wish you all the blessings in the world and in the future to come.